Hello, everybody. This is the Dance Syndrome presentation for the event this weekend. And before we do our introductions, we are just going to talk to you about a few little housekeeping parts. So we are here until 22. We have been given this time slot and we will have enough time for questions as well. If you have questions throughout the session, please use the chat function, which is usually at the bottom of your screen. As we are talking, we might not be able to reply straight away, but we will get to those questions, whether that's at the end or during the presentation as well. If we've got time at the end, we will allow people to ask verbal questions as well. But we've got lots to get through, lots of information to share with you as well. You can have your camera on or off, whichever is comfortable for you. And this session is being recorded so that Aspire can then share it afterwards. So if you do not want to be on this recording, please turn your camera off. It is entirely up to you. If there's anything else that pops up throughout the session, so if there's a ticking noise that you can hear, anything technology that you think, oh, actually, I need to check this, that's all right. Or if I'm sharing my screen and you cannot see the screen, then please just let me know. So I'm going to stop this now. Oh, if it'll let me, because we're going to do our introductions. So, hello everyone, my name is Anna and I am a dance artist with Dance Syndrome. And I am also the Partnership Development Assistant. So I do lots of communication between education sectors, so universities and schools, things like that. So that's my job. I deliver dance, but I also do a lot of emailing and things like that as well. Today, we also have Jen with us. Jen, would you like to introduce yourself?
Yes, hi everyone. My name is Jane Blackwell. I am the founder director for Dance Syndrome. I am also the queen of Dance Syndrome and I love my job.
Wonderful, don't we all? We absolutely love it. I think that's the best thing as well, especially in this sector, because it might have started as a hobby when we were younger as a child, and then you turn it into a career. It's wonderful to have something you love as your job and your career. I think that is wonderful. So, before we tell you any more about who Dance Syndrome are, we're going to have a performance by the founder, Jen. So, I will spotlight Jen so she is big screen for everybody. We ask that everyone please mute themselves whilst we are playing music so that the sound doesn't bounce, things like that. So, when Jen is ready, I am going to press play on some music and enjoy.
There was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this: the fourth and fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing. Thank you.
Fantastic. Wonderful, Jen. Thank you so much for sharing with us. Beautiful, beautiful. So what a beautiful performance. And Jen has also had the pleasure of meeting Alexandra Burke as well, which is absolutely fantastic. And how was that, Jen, when you met Alexandra Burke?
To meet Alexandra Burke was, I couldn't really believe it until I met her. She is my hero, and my absolute fan. I love her so much. It's a dream come true for me. So I love it so much.
Fantastic. Thanks, Jen. So we're going to now tell you a bit more about who Dance Syndrome are. Dance is in the name, and you've just seen some dancing, so that's a little bit of a clue. But I'm just going to share my screen again, because I've got some text on there, which I will also read out, but it's up to you whether you want to read or listen or a bit of both. So Dance Syndrome was founded by Jen Blackwell, who you have just met, and Jen completed a mainstream education and completed all of her exams, but when she left school, her ambition was to teach dance. Jen's family supported her in this mission and attended many short courses across the country to develop her skills. She even travelled to Durham, from where she lived in West Yorkshire, weekly to receive training. However, there were no long-term opportunities. So with the support of her family, Jen was then able to make some connections, and in 2009 received a small pot of funding to send a call out to dancers both with and without disabilities who wanted to join her and dance together. From here, Dance Syndrome was born and has developed over the years to where we are today, a charitable organisation delivering dance activity, performances and training across the country. Every class, training and presentation that we deliver is co-delivered. Now, this is when you have a trained dance artist and a trained dance leader with disabilities working together to create the presentation, the training, or the class. We do lots of different types of delivery from Dance Syndrome, and one of the main ones that we do is leadership training. Now, we have a dance by example training course, and we have a level 0, a level 1 and a level 2. The level 1 and level 2 are Sports England UK accredited, and the training course is for dancers with learning disabilities, for dance artists and support workers to explore Dance Syndrome's model of co-delivered inclusive dance practice. Throughout this training course, everyone takes part in lots of different activities to learn what skills are needed to be a leader and how to create your own dance classes. This leadership training course we can deliver in schools, within universities, for staff, for anyone who wants to either be a dance leader or just know more about it. And if you have a group, for example, you might have a class at school, maybe at secondary school, who's wanting to be a dance leader or learn more about it as part of their maybe dance syllabus, then we can always have a meeting and have a little, give them an insight into what the leadership training course is. And then we can always create a training course to suit them, whether that's the level 0, 1 or 2. We do lots of community work. So before lockdown, we had lots of weekly in-person sessions, and these included everybody dance workshops where we encourage everybody to dance, as simple as it is in the name. And everybody can dance, whether that is the smallest of movements, a smile, a look, anything can be a movement. And that is what we strive for. Everything can be a movement. There is no right answer and there is no wrong answer. We also give one-off or bespoke projects, so such as creating a piece for a school who want to create a project with us. We do mass participation, which is when someone is leading and everyone is just following along, a bit like copy and follow. One of my favourite memories of this is when we were in Edinburgh at the Edinburgh Fringe Festival, and we were dancing on the Royal Mile, and the whole of the Royal Mile were either watching or joining in with us. It was fantastic, absolutely wonderful. We also do weekly online workshops. So throughout this whole year, it was our anniversary, I think last week, of our first Zoom class, and it's been going for the whole year, and we've worked so hard. We do dance training, so we offer an inclusive technique classes, including ballet, contemporary, street and jazz, and these are online at the moment as well. We have DS Collective, which is an inclusive creative session exploring contact improvisation, somatic practice and devising choreography, which we will be outside soon as well with that group, which is so exciting. In a few weeks, we're going to be outside dancing together. We do a lot of advocacy as well. So we do conferences, presentations, workshops, professional and corporate workshops, and university training workshops. So we've worked a lot with NHS students or people who have just recently gone into the medical field, talking about inclusivity and people with learning disabilities and how dance can be a thought form of therapy or inclusion, lots of different areas that we can dip into there. And we do lots of performances across the UK as well, which is super exciting. So Jen, what classes do you deliver at the moment?
At the moment, I deliver ballet with Donna. I also deliver street dance, which is really upbeat and go-getting and lively. And I also teach once on a Thursday morning with the Dance Syndrome Association. So both me and Don love doing that one too.
Yeah, very busy. We're always, there's so many classes as well at the moment online, and we have everybody dance sessions online, so every Tuesday we have a different dance artist and dance leader taking over the session as well, which is fantastic. So some of our sessions you can book on for 6 weeks, some of our sessions you can just do the one class and do it whenever you like, 1 week and then maybe week four or week two or every week. It's entirely up to you, which is fantastic. So we teach lots of classes, lots of presentations, lots of advocacy. We go in schools, we go in community centres, we go to the Brit School, we go to Edinburgh Fringe Festival, lots and lots of different places that we go, which is fantastic. And we've also been recognised for our work, for our dance leadership, for volunteering, for our business model, for our charity as a whole. Jen, would you like to tell people some of the awards we've won?
Absolutely. Yes, I would love to. So the first one that we have won, there we go. Here is the Queen's Award that we have won for voluntary service.
And that is such a special award as well, because that is the equivalent of an MBE as well, which is incredible. So Dance Syndrome have an MBE. How incredible. What other awards have you got there to show us?
I've also got both myself and my mum. We won Inspirational Women of the Year.
Fantastic.
So happy and proud that Mum and I have been given this recognition.
You really have, and you worked so hard. Well, you and your family to start up Dance Syndrome worked so hard to create that opportunities for so many people. If you think about all these people that we've got in our sessions at the moment online, there's so many new people as well joining us, and that has all come from your dream to be a dance teacher, and it's happening, which is fantastic. And having that dream and having this charity now, we can support other people and we're making the dream even bigger, which is fantastic. So we just want to now talk to you about what Dance Syndrome can do to you, and we can do for you. So let me share my screen again. So we can deliver dance and movement classes for your school, your community, your teachers as a teacher day, however it is a training day. We can create project pieces. So say if you have if you're a secondary school teacher and you have GCSE dance there, you might want to have industry professionals come on in and create a project or a piece for your school. And we can do that. We can work together in this collaborative way, this co-production method that we use with your pupils as well. We can perform. You might just want a performance to come along at your school, or you might want to invite us along to your school's performance. You might have a showcase and we might be there with you as well. We can provide lots of training opportunities. So like I said, we've got our dance leadership course, which is for anybody, and you learn the skills to be a leader, specifically a dance leader, but they are transferable skills. We can deliver inclusive training. So this could be for pupils or teachers and teachers, for your staff. If you're wanting more training on just inclusivity in general or disabilities. We can do topic training as well, such as inclusion in practice. So we have worked, like I said before, with NHS students. So we have then spoken with the lecturers and talked about, oh, what would you like us to talk about? Would you like case studies? Would you just like to ask lots of questions to dance leaders, dance artists? So if you have something in mind where you want us to get involved, we can just have a conversation about this and find what suits your school, your pupils, your setting, whatever it is that is. Because we can dip into so many different areas, whether that is dance, disability, inclusion, education. So yeah, get in contact, and disability awareness as well. We can deliver courses on that. We actually have a CPD available now to book. This is with Primary Dance UK and Dance Syndrome. We're working together on this. And we've already done two of these events so far, and they've been wildly successful. It has been incredible. So this is Everybody Dance, an introduction to delivering inclusive dance in schools. And the next session is happening on the 2nd of June, which might be your half term, it might not be, because I know everyone has different half terms, but we tried to match it up with as many half terms as possible. And this training session will include considering where you are with dance. So how confident do you feel? What's your knowledge? We talk about the barriers to dance and how we can overcome them, how we can make dance inclusive and why we make it inclusive. We talk about differentiation and adaptations, because that is so important. Everybody is different. Every physical body is completely different. Everyone's mind is different. And having differentiation and adaptations is important. We also will give you examples of dance exercises that you can take away with you. And we give you dance resources and assessment materials as well. So to book onto this, I'll just stop share so then I can share again to show you. If you're wanting to book onto this, you can go on this link. I'll send the link in the chat now. And it'll come up with an Eventbrite link. And you can click on that, and it's just £12 for the CPD. And you get a certificate at the end as well. So if you are working in schools, you can then prove to your head teacher or the boss, whoever is in charge. You might have a funder who needs to see this. You get a certificate at the end as well to show that you have completed it. I'm just going to share with you what that looks like in case you are booking on. So it's an event page like this, and it has more details about what the event includes here. You can also, because I'm screen sharing, that pops up, have a look at our website. So this is our website, dancesyndrome.co.uk, and have a little look about what else we do, because there's so much that we do and there's so much that is difficult to fit into 20 minutes. We've given you just a quick sum up of who we are, what we do, and what our ethos is. So if you want to find out more, have a little look on our page. If you wanted to join some of our online sessions that are running at the moment from the comfort of your home, you can go onto the events tab here and have a look at all of the different sessions here. So if you have a look down, they'll tell you what the classes are called, when they're on, what time, how much they are, and what to expect. We also have our YouTube page as well. If you want to just have a look at some of the other videos that we've got, some of our performances, and some more information as well. There's so many things that we could talk about, but we are running out of time. Now, we've just got 4 minutes until the end of the session. So now we're going to open up if anyone has any questions. This could be about our experiences, about DanceSyndrome as a whole, or about what we can do in collaboration. I'm also just going to pop my email in the chat as well, so you've got contact details if you want to get in touch with me. But if you lose the email, do not worry. If you head to our social media or our websites, all of the information is there. So I'll just pop my email in here. But does anyone have any questions for me or Jen? It's okay if not. I'm just checking the chat, see if anything's come in. There's some wonderful comments that people have said about, wow, congratulations on the awards and the success. Jen, people are commenting how beautiful the dance was. I'm just saying how incredible Dance Syndrome are, pretty much. Everyone has worked so hard, especially over the last year, but over the last, since, well, 2009, when you started Dance Syndrome with your family, Jen. Everyone has worked so hard to give everybody the opportunity to be dance leaders and to teach a class. Yes, people can donate. I will share my screen to show you how that can happen. But you can either send an email and I can send all the information through. But also we have lots of fundraising opportunities that we have done. If you want to raise money yourself, you can do. You could set up a challenge. If you send me an email and say, I want to do a bike ride, then we can set this up for you. We can set up a Just Giving page. Recently, one of our dance leaders, Becky, has done 1,000 punches a day with boxing. So she had boxing gloves on and her dad had the boxing pads on. 1,000 punches a day, which is incredible. And she raised so much money, over £1,000, which is incredible. But you can also send a donation through the website. So if you look at the fundraising appeal, you can see all of the things we get up to here. And there's so many different ways that you can send donations. And here it tells you all of the information. So like I was saying, if you want to fundraise yourself, we can give you a fundraising pack and a sponsorship form, things like that. We also have lots of ways that you can donate to us, because as a charity, your donations mean so, so much to us. It allows us to provide cheaper dance classes so people can access them. Because not only are we an inclusive dance company for people with disabilities, we also still want to make sure that we are inclusive so that we can access the sessions. So you can see here, we can do a text message donation, where you text dance to different numbers for the amount that you want to pay. So I can copy and paste this in to the chat, just so you have that there. But have a look on our website. We've got so many different ways that you can get in touch with us, get in contact and donate as well. And just in advance, if you are donating, huge thank you. It does mean so much to us. It allows us to do so many more projects and sessions as well. So I've just posted in there the text way to donate. So depending on how much money you want to send, you can send a text. So that is it. That is all the time we have been given for today. So I hope you've enjoyed meeting Jen and myself and hearing more about Dance Syndrome. Please get in contact, send an email if you want to know more. Jen, is there anything you would like to say before we leave?
Thank you so much. You can head over to Dance Syndrome on Facebook. Our website is dancesyndrome.co.uk. If you'd like to find out a bit more about us and what we do online, and for the classes as well. But on the other hand, I'd like to say a massive thank you to everyone. Thank you, Mum, for everything, for making your only daughter, for making my dream come true as a dancer and as a dance leader. So I am massively, I just want to thank my mum and dad, because if it wasn't for the support of my mum and dad, I wouldn't be me in Dance Syndrome, because even though I do have a disability, it doesn't define me of who I am. So I am proud of who I am, even though I do have a disability.
Beautiful words there, Jen, and thank you so much for sharing them. Just want to say again, a huge thank you to everyone for joining us today. Please get in contact. It would be great to see you again to collaborate with your schools, your settings, wherever you are. It'd be great to have another conversation. So just want to say a huge thank you, and we'll speak to you very soon. We'll just stay on here for a few moments if anyone has any questions, but please feel free to go to the next session. Thank you very much, and see you next time. Bye.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Lovely, lovely dancer, Jen. Bye.
Bye. Thank you, Jackie.
Thank you, Mom.
Sue, it's just you left if you want to say anything.
She's been rumbled.
She's been found.
Video won't work either.
Oh no, we could hear you though. But well done,
Oh.
Jen. Well done, Anna. Well done, everyone. Oh no, is it not
You
working?
guys are brilliant. I can't make a video work, but at least you can hear me. So well done to you. That was absolutely brilliant. I thought, oh, hi, Donna. You're hiding around the corner there. I thought that was absolutely brilliant. So well done, guys. Well done all. And Jen, your final comments were magic.
Yeah.
Absolute magic. So, and as was your dancing, I have to say, I think you bowled people away. And there was a comment right up at the front, and they said they didn't realize that the dancing was live.